Now let us see the first stage of accounting cycle, that is a journal. The first stage of accounting cycle is the journal. So the first step of accounting cycle is the record of all the transactions in the books of original entry, that is journal. And the journal is the word which is the Latin word taken from the jor, which means a day wise or the day book or the diary book. Therefore, journal means a day book in day to day business transactions are recorded in chronological order. Journal is the first book of accounts, first book of accounts in which the transactions are recorded immediately after taking place in the business, or after taking the transactions takes place in the business, immediately the transactions has been recorded in the book is called as journal. This is a first book of accounting. This is also called as the first book of accounting. So it is treated as the book of the original entry or the first entry or the prime entry. All the business transactions are recorded in this book before they and posted in the ledger. Before posting these transactions in the ledger, we require to complete the preparation of the journal entries. So journal is the complete and chronological record of the business transactions, where we can record all the transactions in date wise. So it is recorded in a systematic manner, and the process of recording the transactions in journal is called as journalizing. The process of recording the transactions in journal is known as journal entries. Writing the journal entries is known as journalizing. The entries made in the books called as a journal entries. So here, after taking place the transactions in the business, first we need to record the transactions in a book of accounts called as a journal in chronological order. So here there is a format to prepare this journal called as journal format. Passing the entries into the journal called as a journalizing. So here there is a certain format to prepare this journal entries. Here let us see the format of journal. The title of this statement is called as journal entries in the books of here company name, on date. We need to write the period. Period you can write here. Journal entries in the books of so and so company on so and so period. So here the format for the journal is date, particulars, LF, debit, rupees, credit, amounts in rupees. This is a format of journal. So after taking place the transactions in the business, we require to record the transactions in rough book. Then we need to transfer the transactions into the journal format as journal entries. So this is the format. This is the standard format of a journal, where we will record the date of transaction, the amount, the details of the transaction, what is to be debited and what is to be credited, the ledger folio, debit amounts in rupees and credit amounts in rupees. These are the parts of the journal format. Now let us see what different parts that we are using in journal format. So the first one is date. Why the date column used? How the date column used in the format of journal? Date column is used to write the date of the transactions and which the transactions takes place in the business. For example, here the transaction has done in the business on January 1st, 2020. This is the column which is used to write the date of the transaction with the month, date and also the year. So here the year of the transactions may not repeat for every transaction, because generally all the transactions may be done in the same year. Once you have written that year number, means need not to write for the remaining transactions here. For example, there is a one more transaction on January 5th. Need not to write again 2020, because the same year will be continued, right? So January 5th, 2020. Now here the particulars. So date column is used to write the date of the transactions takes place in the business. Whereas the particulars column is used to write or record the details of transaction. The details of transaction. Which account should be debited and which account should be credited. So the particulars column is used to write the details of the transaction in terms of debit account as well as the credited account. Debited account and the credited account. This is what the purpose of a particulars column. And ledger folio is used to write the page number of ledger, book, account. What is the purpose of ledger folio? LF means ledger folio. LF means it is ledger folio. Simply we are writing it as LF, ledger folio. Ledger folio is used to write the page number of the ledger book account. Here, for example, you are preparing the account in journal entries in ledger book. We need to write that page number in the ledger folio column. For example, you have prepared some X account in page number 6 in ledger book. That page number 6 will write here under the ledger folio column. So that number is used as a reference to identify or to find the respective account in the ledger book. And the debit and credit columns in terms of amounts are used to write the amounts of the corresponding account. For example, the transaction is worth of 1000. So we need to write the amount of the account in the respective account. And credit column is used to write the amount of the account against to the respective account. So these two columns are used to write the amount, the total amount of the debited to the respective account and the total amount that should be credited in the corresponding account. These two columns are used to write the amount of the accounts for the respective accounts, debit as well as the credit accounts. So they are the parts of the format of a journal. So we need to write journal title followed by date, particulars, ledger folio, debit and credit amounts in rupees. Now let us take one simple example, the simple transaction to pass the journal entry in the format. let's take one example. For example, January 1st 2020 purchased machinery rupees 15,000. This is a transaction done on January 1st 2020. Now we need to post or pass the entry for this transaction. We need to pass the entry for the transaction done on January 1st 2020, that is purchased machinery rupees 15,000. First we need to understand the nature of transaction, whether it is credit transaction or cash transaction. So we have three types of business transactions, that is relating to the persons, relating to the assets, relating to the expenses or incomes or losses or gains. So here, by observing this transaction, we will come to know that this is not relating to the persons, because there is no person name in this transaction. So this is not the personal account. See, here persons, assets and expenses or incomes. These are the three categories. So as there is no person name in the transaction, then it is not belongs to or relating to the person. So we need not to apply the rule of personal account. Now, the second one is, here asset. Is there any asset in the transaction? Yes. We are purchasing. What we are purchasing? Machinery. Machinery is an asset. Machinery is an asset. So, as it is asset, assets are relating to the real account. Assets are relating to the real account. If it is persons, personal account. If it is assets, real account. If it is expenses, nominal account. Right? See, here the machinery is an asset to the business. Assets are relating to the real account. According to the real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What is the rule of real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What goes out. See, here what we are doing? We are purchasing machinery. So machinery is related to the real account, and according to real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. When we purchase machinery, machinery will go out or come in? Yes, it is coming into the business. Hence, it should be debited. So, machinery is relating to the real account and it should be debited. Debited for 15,000 rupees. So, as per the double entry bookkeeping system, we need to record two aspects of transaction. One is debit and second one is credit. So we have identified the debit aspect. Now we need to find the credit aspect of this transaction. So here we have purchased machinery worth of rupees 15,000. 15,000 rupees is cash we are paying for purchasing machinery. What is cash? What is the nature of cash? Cash is an asset. And assets are related to the real account. According to real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here we are paying 15,000 rupees in terms of cash. Cash is going out from the business, hence it should be credited. So the second aspect of this transaction is cash. Cash is also related to the real account, hence it should be credited. As per the transaction, cash should be credited for 15,000 rupees. This is a process of analyzing the transaction by using the types and rules of accounts. What we did here, we have identified the nature of transaction. After that, we have identified the key words in the transaction, that is machinery and the amount, followed by applied the suitable account and also the rule of account in order to record in the journal format. So after identifying, analyzing the transactions aspects, both debit and credit, now we need to post in the journal format. So what is the date of transaction? January 1st 2020. What is debited? Machinery. What is credited? Cash. Now, while posting or passing this entry for the transaction in the format, the debit account should be start from the edge, left edge of the particular column, that is machinery account. Here account write in short form, that is as A by C. And here the right edge of the column, we should write it as a DR. Here as it is debited, we can write it is in a short form, that is as a DR. And the credited account should write in the particular column by leaving some space from left to right as a cash account. We need to leave some space from left to right, then write the name of the account, that is credited. So machinery account data to machinery account data to cash account, worth of rupees. What is the amount of this transaction? 15,000 rupees debit paid amount and 15,000 rupees credit. See, the debit and credit columns are used to write the amount of account in the corresponding row, and the credit column is used to write the amount of account, the amount of account against the account. So this is a process of posting or passing the journal entries for the transactions. So here need not to write here CR. Here we are passing account in the journal with the word to means default, it will be treated as a credited account. Need not to write the CR here. Machinery account data to cash account 15,000 and 15,000. Now here about the ledger folio, after posting this entry into ledger book in respective account, that is machinery account and cash account, then we need to take up the page number where we have prepared this machinery account and cash account in ledger book. That page number we need to write here. For example, after completion of this entries, we have prepared machinery account in ledger book in page number 11. Means here, instead of searching all the pages in ledger book, directly we can find the machinery account in page number 11 in ledger book. Similarly, if you prepared the cash account in ledger book in page number 7, directly we will go to the page number 7 in ledger book in order to find the cash account details. Need not to search all the pages in ledger book. So this is the purpose of writing the ledger folio or the page number of the ledger book in which the accounts are opening. After completion of passing the entry for the transaction, immediately we need to write the narration. It is also very very important for the journal entries. After passing the entry, we require to write the narration, and the narration must start. It is mandatory to start the narration with the word being or for. Being or for. So the narration is a simple statement which reveals the meaning of the entry passed in the journal. Narration is a simple statement which reveals or discloses the meaning or details of the entry passed in journal. In this transaction, we have purchased machinery for cash for 15,000 rupees. Immediately after passing the entry, we need to write the narration as being purchased machinery. So this is the narration for the entry. Means by seeing this narration, immediately we'll come to know that yes, this entry has passed for purchase of this machinery. For that, we need to write the narration for each and every transaction. After passing the entry for the transaction, immediately we need to write the narration for the transaction. Like this, we need to pass the journal entries for the transactions conducted in the business. Okay, so what we have done, we have written the date of transaction takes place in the business, followed by as per the rules and types of accounts. Based on the nature of transaction, we have classified into debited account and credited account. Accordingly, we pass the entry here, machinery account, debtor to cash account, and the amounts for the corresponding accounts. So here machinery account is debtor, so we need to write in debited account, debit column in the amounts, and cash account is credited, hence we write the amounts in credit column for the corresponding account. So here the machinery account debtor to cash account is the entry for the transaction. Now let us take one more example or the transaction. That is, salaries paid or paid salaries. January 31st paid salary ₹1,000. Paid salary 1,000. This is the transaction takes place in the business on January 31st. So here this January 31st in the year 2020. Need not to write the year number every time, because mostly the transactions are conducting in the same year, except the accounting period from April 1st to March 31st in the next year. If the business is taking the accounting period as January 1st to December 31st, we will take the same year as we will conduct the transactions in the same year. So need not to write the year number every time. So January 31st, paid salary ₹1,000. There is no name of the person, name of the business, or name of the firm, name of the company in the transaction. Hence, it is not the credit transaction, or it is not related to the personal account, because there is no name of the persons. Then, second one, either it is real account or the nominal account, or this transaction is related to both the accounts, real and nominal accounts. So here the key points or the key words are salary and the amount. Salary and the amount. Salary is the nature of expenses for the business. What is the nature of salary? Expenditure for the business. It is not the loss or the income or the gain or the asset. It is expenditure in nature. So as it is expenditure in nature, salary is related to the nominal account. Nominal account. What is the rule of nominal account? Debit, expenses, credit, incomes. As it is expenditure to the business, so the salary account should be debited, because debit the expenditure and credit the incomes. So salary is relating to the nominal account. Nominal account that should be debited. That should be debited. And the second one is 1000 rupees we are paying. 1000 rupees in terms of cash. So 1000 rupees is the cash. What is the nature of this cash? So cash is related to the asset that is related to real account. What is the rule of real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. When you are paying salaries to the employee, the cash is going out from the business. So here cash, as we know, cash is belongs or relating to the real account. The real account. And in real account, debited or credited, as the cash is going out from the business, that should be credited. That should be credited. See, each and every transaction should assume from the business point of view, not from the outside. So here cash is real account, cash is relating to the real account, and according to real account this should be credited. So we have identified the two aspects of this transaction, that is debit aspect and the credit aspect. So salary is debited, cash is to be credited. Now we need to pass the entry for the same in journal. So January 31st, salary account, debtor 2, by leaving some space, remember this is very important. Salary account, debtor 2, cash account. So what is the amount of this transaction? 1000 rupees. So 1000 rupees debited to salary account. And 1000 rupees is credited to cash account. So we should write in the corresponding columns, salary account debit in debit column, cash account credited in credit column. Once you pass this entry, then we need to write the narration immediately. That is being. Narration must start with the word being. Being salary paid. This is our narration. Immediately draw one line only for the particulars column. Only for the particulars column. So what we have done here? We have taken one transaction and identified the nature of transaction. Then that is expenditure. The nature of transaction is expenditure. Expenditures are related to the nominal account. According to the nominal account, debit the expenditure. So salary is debited. And cash, the second aspect is the cash. Cash is real account. Real account, as per the rule of real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. As cash is going out in terms of salaries, so that should be credited. So the same we are passing in the form of entry in the journal. Then we have written the narration of the transaction, being salary paid. So this is a process of passing the journal entries by using the transactions made or conducted by the business during a particular period. So passing the journal entries are playing a very, very important role in preparing ledger, book accounts, as well the trial balance and also the final accounts. If you made any mistake, any error in passing the journal entries here, this will affect on the performance of the business. This will affect on the ledger book, trial balance and also the final accounts. So my dear students, while preparing the ledger journal or passing the journal entries, you must take utmost care identifying or understanding the nature of transaction, applying the rules of accounts and passing the journal entries in the journal. So this is very important stage or the crucial stage in process of accounting. So this is the first stage of accounting cycle, that is called journal. Okay.